From the time I read Anna, I was in love with her fire. She's taught me not to doubt myself and to embrace my instincts and my spontaneity. And I'm really sad to say goodbye to her because I feel like she is, at times, everything I could be. She's kind of the best of me. And so I hope I can carry her for the rest of my life, but I'll be so sad to put her to bed.
When James Bly was offered to me, it was said, okay, you've got this really great character, but he's gay. When I heard that, I thought, no, I've got this really great character and I want him because he's gay. He taught me a lot about tolerance, acceptance, and how to really treat people with respect. So I think he's made me a better person, for sure.
Playing Sarah has taught me how to be a little bit more considered. In life, I think we have so much coming at us all the time, and just living in the 1950s for 7 years, reminding myself of the dignity of my grandparents, I guess a little bit of them has resurrected inside of me, and I feel probably more gracious. I try to be quieter. I've also learned so much about the Holocaust. Playing a Holocaust survivor has been one of the great privileges of my career. And it's something I take very seriously, and it's something that I have been very moved by over the 7 years.
It's hard not to take away a bit of Roy after having played him for so long. And I hope I take, Roy's capability. I'm not very handy in private life, but obviously being a farmer, Roy's very handy. So I hope I learn something from that.
I think Olivia taught me that love saves the day. And that it's okay to be a bit nervous. She's a bit nervous, you know, and I'm a bit nervous, but kind of muddle on through, and I've enjoyed that. And it's a good lesson that you don't have to be smooth.
I think an actor always learns something from the roles they play. And I've sort of learned a lot about my mum from doing this, because she was very secretive and would never share anything about her life. And so it's sort of helped to reinforce my determination, not only because of my mother, but also because of playing this character who was so hidebound because of those beliefs that you don't talk about anything that could possibly embarrass the family. It's made me doubly determined to not be like that with my own children.
Not to take things for granted. Henry is a guy who seems to have it all together and keeps kind of getting the rug pulled out from under him. He always manages to collect himself again and find his feet, but never as confident as he was previously, or at least in a different way. If he's taught me anything, it's to, you know, to kind of face it head on and be prepared. And no matter what, you know, kind of comes your way, there's always a way forward, there's always a way through it. So yeah, I think inner strength and perseverance.
She's a bit more forthright than me. I think she deals with confrontation better than me, so maybe I should learn from that.
I kind of like the idea that a normal man on our screens can be strong. And normal doesn't mean boring, and good values are interesting. So I've just really embraced and playing him for those qualities, and rejoicing in the normality, and in decency, and in good manners.
Yeah, I'll know what not to do. And so, when you're trying to deal with stuff, that's for sure. But I like his ethic. I like where his mind's at. Yeah, it's a character that I feel very proud to have played, you know. So yeah, there's a few takeaways for sure.
Whether it sticks or not, she's got a hell of a lot more humility than I do, and I think that's been something to learn. Yeah.